Jack, in your book, you write about a conversation between you and then and Donald Trump, who was then a citizen, where he complained to you about an African-American employee in the casino's finance department. Can you just explain what happened?
Sure. It was really a dialogue that we had over a couple of years, Anderson, but one particular instance where he referred to, who was our chief financial officer, by the way, not just an employee, the top financial officer in the organization. And he complained to me that he didn't really like having a black guy counting his money. He went on to say, what I want counting my money is short guys with yarmulkes on their head. So it was a pretty shocking conversation.
Was this out of the ordinary for him to say?
Well, no, he had complained several times that he wasn't happy with this particular employee. But it was really the first time that he really honed in on the fact that he didn't like him simply because he was black. Because he went on to say in this conversation that that he perceived this guy as being lazy. And then he said, but that's probably not his fault because laziness is a trait in blacks. So he made it very clear that this was a black issue.
He actually
did not want.
He actually spelled it out in exactly those words.
He spelled it out in exactly those words.
What did you, I mean, how do you respond to something like this from a guy who's obviously your boss?
Yeah, well, Anderson, first off, I was shocked, but I actually took the approach that I said, Donald, you know, first off, you can't be talking this way. This is wrong. You don't want people to know you think this way or you would say things like this. And I tried to back him down from that perspective. But it was very clear that he wanted this individual removed from his job simply because he was black.
When you hear the president now say that he's not a racist and that he is, quote, the least racist person, knowing him, having worked with him, do you believe that?
Well, I don't. And I do believe he's a racist. And further to the point, Anderson, I believe anybody that has spent substantial amount of time around him in a casual atmosphere, whether it's business or at dinner or at lunch, I believe it would be very difficult that he wouldn't express these feelings to them over time. I just find it very hard to believe that there aren't more people who know him that don't believe exactly what I believe, but for one reason or another, they're not willing to say it publicly, that he is a racist.
Do you think he realizes he's a racist? Do you think he knows it?
Well, listen, I think he's delusional, and so I think deep down in his mind, he wants to believe that he's not. But I believe that there is a pattern of conversation throughout his entire life where he has talked in racial stereotypes. I think he's also been denigrating toward women. And I think this is the way he believes deep down inside of himself. And so, you know, does he believe it? I think at some level he has to know exactly what he is because he continues to present this image of himself.
Mm. Well, Jack O'Donnell, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you, Anderson.
An important footnote, when the book first came out, O'Donnell says Citizen Trump called him a, quote, disgruntled employee. Then in a 1997 interview, he said O'Donnell's recollections were, quote, probably true. 2 years later, he denied it all.